Good morning, dear friends. I am happy to stand before you today to explain the accounting rules with examples. Please remember that the number of this video is R6. This is a continuation of the video R5. Before explaining the accounting rules, I like to place a request before all of you. If you are watching my video for the first time, you may not be familiar with my pronunciation. So I request you to activate the CC icon or script icon. Touch the video in a mobile, you can see the CC icon. And in a laptop or computer, you can see the script icon. Activate it, then you will get the script of my lecture also. Then let us proceed. Example number 6. Goods costing rupees 25,000. Sold to Rajan for rupees 35,000. Cost of goods 25,000 and it sold for 35,000. First question is, what is to be recorded, 25,000 or 35,000? Here 35,000 is to be recorded, because that is the total revenue. Then let's analyze the transaction. Standard pattern is, identify the two affected accounts and apply the GRIDA formula to both the accounts. Think from the point of view of business. See, here the transaction is this: goods costing rupees 25,000, sold to Rajan for 35,000. There is no mention as to whether cash is received or not. And at the same time, name of the customer is specifically given in this statement. Therefore, we can assume that this is a credit transaction. See, goods sold to Rajan on credit. Rajan owes money to the business. Therefore, Rajan is a debtor of the business. Similarly, goods went out of the business. Therefore, the two affected accounts are Rajan's account and goods account. Then let us take both the accounts one by one and analyze. Rajan's account. GRIDA formula. Group, rule, increase or decrease, apply. First, group. Rajan is a debtor of the business. Debtor is an asset. Therefore, Rajan's account falls under group number 1. Then rule. Rule of group number 1 is increase debited and decrease credited. Then here increase or decrease. A new debtor came into existence. Therefore, Rajan's account increased. Then apply. Rajan's account increased. Rule is increase debited. Therefore, Rajan's account is to be debited. Then take goods account. Here goods are sold. Therefore, in order to distinguish between purchase of goods and sale of goods, we can describe sale of goods as sales. Sales account is an income also. Then let's apply GRIDA formula. Group, rule, increase or decrease, apply. First, group. Sale of goods is a source of revenue to the business. Therefore, it can be included under group number 2, capital, liabilities and incomes. Then rule. Rule of group number 2 is increase credited and decrease debited. Then here increase or decrease. Sales happen. Amount of sales increased. Then apply. Sales increase. Rule is increase credited. Therefore, sales account is to be credited. Then our conclusion. Rajan's account is to be debited and sales account is to be credited. Therefore, we will get a journal entry. Rajan's account debtor 50,000, to sales account 50,000. Then let us take example number 7. Monthly rent of rupees 5,000 paid in cash. Our standard pattern is identify the two affected accounts and apply the GRIDA formula to both the accounts. Think from the point of view of business. Rent paid and it is paid in cash. Therefore, the two affected accounts are rent account and cash account. First, take the rent account. Then GRIDA, group, rule, increase or decrease, apply. Group, rent is an expense. Therefore, rent falls under group number 1. Then rule. Rule of group number 1 is increase debited and decrease credited. Then here increase or decrease. A new expense, that is rent incurred. Therefore, there is increase in rent. Then apply. Rent increased. Rule is increase debited. Therefore, rent account is to be debited. Then take the second account, cash account. GRIDA, group, rule, increase or decrease, apply. First group, cash is an asset, therefore it falls under group number 1. Then rule, rule of group number 1 is increase debited, decrease credited. Here increase or decrease, cash has gone out of the business, therefore cash decreased. Then apply, cash decreased. Rule is decrease credited, therefore cash is to be credited. That means, conclusion is, rent is to be debited and cash is to be credited. Then we will get the journal entry, rent account at 5,000 to cash account 5,000. I conclude. I hope that all of you enjoyed this presentation. Please be kind enough to note down your comments in the comment box. Please be kind enough to subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching. Bye and see you again.